And here is the Writer's Almanac for Tuesday, the 20th of August, 2019. It was on this day, 1940, Winston Churchill delivered a speech to the House of Commons with the famous line, "Never in the field of human conflict was so much owed by so many to so few." It was in the midst of the Battle of Britain. He was referring to the Royal Air Force who had held off the German Luftwaffe. Winston Churchill wrote all of his own speeches before he became prime minister. He was considered somewhat old-fashioned, but after the war began, his dramatic style fit the mood of the country. His father, Lord Randolph Churchill, served in Parliament and was famous for his spontaneous speeches, but Winston Churchill labored over every one. He researched them, planned out the speech in his head, dictated it aloud, revised it, and rehearsed it over and over, sometimes sitting in a bathtub. It's the birthday of the poet Heather McHugh, San Diego, 1948, who said, "I have always lived on waterfronts. If you live on the edge of an enormous mountain or an enormous body of water, it's harder to think of yourself as being so important. That seems useful to me, spiritually." Went to Harvard when she was 16, sold her first poem to The New Yorker a year later. Her books of poetry include Hinge and Sign and Upgraded to Sirius. It's the birthday of H.P. Lovecraft, born Providence, Rhode Island, 1890, who wrote science fiction, fantasy, and horror. His father had a nervous breakdown when he was a boy. Lovecraft was raised by his mother, two aunts, and his grandfather, who all lived together. The books of H.P. Lovecraft, still widely available, books like The Dreams in the Witch House and other weird stories. H.P. Lovecraft, who said, "I never ask a man what his business is, for it never interests me. What I ask him about are his thoughts and dreams." And it's the birthday of the novelist Jacqueline Susann, born Philadelphia, 1918, came to New York to become an actress, did some commercials, had bit parts, worked as a model, wrote a book about her poodle, and then in 1966 she published a novel, Valley of the Dolls, about three young women in show business who are addicted to barbiturates, which they call dolls. The world of publishing hated Valley of the Dolls. Everyone agreed that it was trash. Truman Capote said Jacqueline Susann looked like a truck driver in drag, and all the negative publicity only increased the sales. It sold 8 million copies in paperback. Here's a poem by Fred Chappell entitled "The Story." Once upon a time, the farmer's wife told it to her children while she scrubbed potatoes. There were wise ravens in it, and a witch who flew into such a rage she turned to brass. The story wandered about the countryside until adopted by the palace waiting maids, who endowed it with three magic golden rings and a handsome prince named Felix. Now it had both strength and style, and visited the household of the jolly merchant, where it was seated by the fire and given a fat gray goose and a comic chambermaid. One day, alas, the story got drunk and fell in with a crowd of dissolute poets. They drenched it with moonlight and fever and fed it words from which it never quite recovered. Then it was old and haggard and disreputable, carousing late at night with defrocked scholars and the swaggering sailors in Rattlebone Alley. That's where the novelists found it. A poem by Fred Chappell, "The Story," from an anthology of poems published by Louisiana State University Press entitled The Yellow Shoe Poets and used by permission here on the Writer's Almanac. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.